Beni, make you tell me where you dey. Tijani, make you tell me where you dey. Ataribo, make you tell me where you dey. Ayobo, make you tell me where you dey. Papilo, make you tell me where you dey. Erikejo, for make you tell me where you dey. Walele, walele, where you dey?
Yeah, oh.
Say walele, walele, where you dey?
My brother, where you dey?
Okocha, make you tell me where you dey. Aga Wonder, make you tell me where you dey. Okoronkwo, make you tell me where you dey. Sigaruba, make you tell me where you dey. Olise, make you tell me where you dey. Udeze, make you tell me where you dey. Ikeshorumu, make you tell me where you dey. Akuwego, make you tell me where you dey. Ayosi Kenya, I say where you dey. Ababa Yaru, make you tell me where you dey. Ujiwe, make you tell me where you dey. Our Super Eagles, I say where una dey.
The chairman, the tribal government, my director, the director and head of staff, the doctor, your Royal Highness, we are happy to meet you today, sir. This journey we are in today, we are beginning this journey far back, as far as 3 years back, sir. And the local also is aware of it. Our journey is not, it has to do with peaceful coexistence in this, in both Saraji and Sahare. Last time we came, last 2-3 years ago, that we came down here, we tend to invite both communities into a neutral ground to discuss a way forward in furthering peaceful coexistence in this community. But as God will have it, we are unable to achieve that goal. This time around, we now come in another form, using sport as a universal language to further complement your role in ensuring peaceful coexistence in both communities. The competition I'm about to play is sponsored by your own son here, Umar Balogun. Just to complement your own role in ensuring that both Saraji and Sahare live together peacefully. Before we started this thing, we tended to start from Ofa and Yanile. We now thought this was about, it's better to follow the adage that says that charities begins at home. That was bring this thing down here, sir. So that's just what I have to say about this thing on this point. I will invite my director to shed more light on this thing that we are trying to do here, sir. Thank you so much.
Well, just as my friend, my child, has just said, we've been on this journey about three or four years. And when we started, and even when we started this particular one, when we're inviting people, there's something that comes to mind. I say, Bakama will not be invited because he's also part of us. And when you are, when in fact it was an oversight that you did not even write a letter to Bakama, I said, don't bother about Bakama. Because he's also part of us. If he will hear it outside, he will not say, what are we doing? He will know that it is what we've been trying to do. And what we're doing is that we look at the human being. There's nothing, also from business perspective, there's no achievement that can be done without peace. There can never be any investor in the two communities if we are not, you know, in the peace together. And there can never be any infrastructure that will be sustained if both of us are keep and we keep fighting each other. And at my own level, as a small boy, as a way, charity begins at home, that we will do something what our elders have been doing. We need to show our elders that even when they are no more, we will continue what they have started. And I think the best way to do it is to use sports to achieve that. And I also want to thank our Royal Father and all the people around the Royal Father who have been making sure that you know, we have, the both community are able to sleep at rest. And I also want to pray for our father, you know, for the God Almighty to continue to be with you and be with the members of the family and the two community as well. Well, we are not doing anything so special, but just to compliment your efforts. We are not doing anything so special, but just to let you know that we, your sons, I think we are listening to your pain about what do we do to live together. And after this competition, it will not stop here by the special grace of Allah. We will move to other communities where crisis has happened and show them that ISRD, we are leader when it comes to peace. You know, in the times of conflict and the peace resolution, we are leaders. That's why our differences are not that we have agreed to understand that we are human beings, we must live together. And that's exactly what we want to show other communities within the state, even beyond the states. Once we receive the royal blessing from our father, and I believe that one of the things that actually lacking is because there is no respect for elders. There is no respect for leaders. And I think in this competition, in my idea, is for us to install, you know, for us to cultivate the habit of respecting our leaders, our elders, not people, not really our parents. Our leaders are parents. Our leaders, both the traditional and the political, they are leaders. God has chosen them. It is not by us. By us, it's just coincidence. So we pray for Almighty Allah to continue to be with our father and all the people that are here. Thank you very much. I also want to see this opportunity to present a little information about the key game for our father. So I mean, the Almighty Allah continue to bless him and be with him.
Members of your intervention, my chiefs, distinguished ladies, distinguished gentlemen. It is a sadness to me that something that some other people, maybe one or two people started up, maybe centuries ago, develop confidence on one another and they place themselves on hold, that despite their differences, despite their tribal and their ethnic and cultural differences, they choose among themselves to live together. But that is when we look at history. Whenever one moved here, the other one moved near that. When they moved, this one, so, and eventually they settled permanently in a place. Because of that trust. When that trust was there, they lived together. Initially, they were living this. When they were growing, this culture is different. We want to maintain our distinct culture. That's why the fact that we are living together, that was the separation. So that one culture does not consume the other, but there should be distinction. That was the distinction. Otherwise, initially, they were together. But in Nana says, okay, we are together, we have confidence in one another. Let us think so that the people will know that you are here, a distinct culture, you are here, a distinct, but those not distinct. And that was why the confidence was there. Because if that confidence has not been there right from the first day, wallahi, that has not been like this, like that, they would have been miles apart.
That's true.
And when I was reading a book written by Professor Ade Ajayi, now late, a former VC of the University of Uganda, is a professor of history. He has written so many history about humans and relationship between Yoruba and other tribes in Nigeria. When he was making this, he specifically in his book made reference to Saraje and Share as a vivid example of the relationship that has existed between Numpi race and the Congaris. And even that to this thing, down to even your villages in the north, major states where you have Numpi, There are some villages today that have Yoruba names. Even Niger State. Just, you know. There are some villages, even around Macquarie and that. That has shown this thing. I remember in 2020, to be precise, maybe 2013 or 2014, either around November, December, the then governor of Niger State married his two daughters out. So he wanted us to come and celebrate with him because before he got those two daughters married, the two of them are back PhD. So he invited so many traditionalists across Nigeria. So I left and attended the invitation. Lemi Ofidoma was there. Lemi Adama was there, some other traditional. So when they announced the room where we were, when they announced the arrival of Olafe for you, it should be whispered to me that I should want to receive him. So I want to receive this thing. Then he said we should stay together. He told me, I'm really joking with Olafe that this is your brother. You stay together. So when I sat down, I introduced myself to when I sat down, they said, oh, my brother. He said, oh, you is not complete without me. Like if you come to my palace, there's nobody who come and laugh that will not have anything. That even if you come to his palace, there's a section within the palace that are dominated by the people. That Mumpi and your brother have been together right from the onset of history. And that was what motivated the Etunupi that we split to say. So he said, in fact, everybody was just laughing. But this is it. Then, that relationship that existed between the two communities, that everybody in the whole world was making the best of, is that, have we destroyed it or we are sustaining it? Because there are certain things you don't joke with. You don't joke with your history. You don't joke with your achievement. Irrespective of the retirement be this. Because that is your pride. That is why you can raise your head. That is your pride. If there are different, you know, husband and wife, even if they are taking themselves, almost slaughtering themselves, when you come to the year of children, they come together, they plan together. That time you don't see anything because the father loved the children and the mother also loved the children. That time of thing, you don't have anything. So why? Even husband and wife, they used to crisis. But we blow our own out of proportion. We blow our own out of proportion. Instead of, we have responsible leadership. Who knows the history? Who knows how big they are believed? But we have so many things that you can refer to that will be chin on each, on either side, on the two of us. No. By the time you invoke that one, everybody will be sober. But the time you say that, things, oh, we want to reinvent. In the process of reinventing, because when you bring innovation, there will be a clash between innovation and the existing order. You understand? Let us go to the base. We should not concord what is not there. We should not try to... all of us, they say we are traditional rulers. Am I the founder of this true?
No.
So, what are they asking me to come and do there? Not to uphold what the other people have been doing. Am I here to come and introduce new thing?
No.
So that is what they call a traditional. You look at what the past, how do they live? How do they relate with others? That is the hard course, because government doesn't want to abolish it. They can first say we don't need traditional blessing, but we are asked to be the custodian of the past. So that when we are here, the present generation will remind them of the past. That is the problem. That's what is called traditional ruler. You look at what happened in the past. We are not here bringing new things. We are not bringing any innovation. Anytime you bring issue to us, we'll go and find that
This kind of vision that you brought before, how was it when so-so person was there? How was it when, how was it? So this is traditional. And that is why when you, whenever you come before us, we refer you to the back. That during the reign of so-so person, this is what happened. Because all these things are history. But when we uphold it, then we now respect the past people. And again, we'll be able to sustain it. If you introduce modernity into your tradition will fade away. Eventually, it will not have no value. Because you are not telling the people, or you are not bringing the people what they don't know. We are children. What are the, our parents did? What did they do during their time? What are their grandfather did? How their great grandfather did? What happened during their time? What are the artifacts? What are your symbol of tradition? It's a kind of thing that make tradition. And that is why, in our own case, we make sure that we sustain this thing. I used to tell people, Holy Papa, we don't have a problem. It's you and the others that have a problem. There are things even Holy Papa is saying, make people embarrassing. If they are starting, if I do, charge people embarrassing. So we are now living in isolation. So authority is now being usurped from those who are supposed to have control of the authority. The truth is here. If you say, they will banish you. If you don't want the truth, eventually you want lies. The moment you are, you live on lie, you continue to have crisis. But the moment you go to the base and have the truth, when night and you learn it, you never learn it. Once you agree, if I'm a one hybrid person, I will not pretend. This is how God wanted me to be, and I'll be proud of it. So, when you are bringing this thing, I want you to have all this at the bottom of your mind. It's not only the game that people share, play, drink beer, just celebrate and go away. It is going to be more than that. You have to go to the base. You have to go to the ground. And whoever is the leadership on both sides, you tell them, what are we going to get? Those of us that God bestowed leadership upon this time around. What are we going to tell our God? What are we going to tell our ancestors? That have you built on what they have been able to build? Or have you destroyed what they have been able to build? Because everybody will have the answer to either openly or secretly. No matter the position of them, where everybody is occupied, everybody must answer one day. Everybody must answer one day for God that created us. When we are doing certain things, if we are doing bad, our ancestors in the grave, their spirit will continue to cause us. When we are doing good, following their footsteps, you will see that we continue to have blessing because their spirit will continue to bless us. We don't look at anybody. Your conscience, some people want to victimize you, castigate you. Once your conscience is clear, is that God that brings life into your body that you fear, not human being. So thank you very much for this organization. And I believe God will use it as a foundation rock, a big rock that nobody can break for the future of peaceful coexistence between the people of Saraji and Share. I would have put on the
guys, compatriots, Nigeria's global, to serve our father's land with love and strength and faith. The labor of our heroes past shall never be in vain. To serve with heart and mind, one nation burning, freedom is our unity. Thank you very much. In this community here in Kwara State, we believe strongly in the efficacy of prayer.
For today, give much thanks to Almighty Allah that has
giving us the wisdom, particularly our young ones, thinking about a very formidable competition of this time that is aimed at fostering and cementing peace between Saraji community and Shaare community. Atlas Wahada Watahada will make this, the competition a very peaceful one. We beseech God in our fervent prayers to guide and guard the players throughout the competition. And to the organizers, may Allah continue to bless you. May Allah reward you immensely. For all the spectators, Allah will continue to be with us. Thy Lord will be our strength. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillahir Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmi Din, Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in, Ihdina Siratal Mustaqim. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح رأيت الناس يهتدون في دين الله أفواجا فسر كيف الحمد لله بقوته وكرمه. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين. Before I hand over the microphone to you, the great governor of Kwara said that Allah continue to pray for his wisdom. May God be with him. Grant him a very peaceful and successful time throughout his regime in Kwara.
It's officially introducing the Ladon Boys, the unity team from Saraji and Lafiaji, meeting today. From Saraji and Shaare, Ladon FC, clad in their very colorful color. And now they are presenting officials who also meet the executive chairman. Now get ready for good photograph. Just keep a space for the executive chairman, Ladov and Makaba. I've been told that there's going to be another very tough final here after this game. It's going to be very tough. What's it, Buga? So the United and the youngsters of Saraji will be playing the final. Now the lecture unity team from Saraji. Now the competition, I've been told, is going to be attracting a lot of prizes before the final. Who is coming up this weekend, Saturday or Sunday? Please get ready for good photograph. And let's come on, sir. Please come here.
Accredited officials in your t-shirt that you didn't give Mr. Sports. I'm jealous. Please stay here for your official. Oluide, please. Very good. Very good. Next.
Very good. Okay, thereafter.
You know, it's going to be in a colorful magazine for the closing ceremony where our governor, His Excellency Alhaji Dr. Fatah Ahmed. Gentlemen of the press, come on.
Hello, Kiakiao, Chap Chap.
Thank you very much. Now the chairman will stay after they take their position.
Then he will now come and invite the executive chairman alone. So go into the field after the kickoff, you now usher him back. That's the protocol.
Very good referee, I know him. He has handled so many Premier League matches. Very athletic, very fast. They call him Fair Play Anywhere. Assisted by Alalade and of course Jambari.
For pre-match formalities, that's what people say. After taking pictures, now
The coaches are giving them instructions. They have just about a minute to go. They take their position, and of course, the game will start. With the official kickoff by the executive chairman, who used to play football in his day. Let's see whether he's going to be able to score a goal into this game. Football unites everybody, it's a unifying factor. And I'm delighted that nobody talks about ethnicity when it comes to football. Nobody talks about language. And of course, you can see that it's only football that unites everybody together. Don't forget. Keep on, Mr. Man. You get suspension for that next time, okay? The ceremony is on.
Now my chairman is about to have a few days, and this is the executive chairman of the Delta Governor. And that's another. He takes a shot. He's a goal. Don't flip the ball, sorry. Flip the ball, Mr. Man. Flip the ball. Don't flip the ball. I was at two moves and I was invited to see the negative chairman who is not here. Congratulations, we are proud of you. Let's put our hands together. Thank you very much. We are proud of you. Thank you. Good luck. Now we're going to be starting the nation commentary. Today I've gotten the team list of the two teams. Like I said, the weather is very sunny. Ah, Uja, my very good friend, he's always hosting me in Share. And the two teams are battle ready. I can see that we have the Olumoro boys, the coach of Ladov, starting the picture now. What can he do with the ball now? This is the team now from Ahono. What can he do? He tried to put his opponent quickly now. And this is Love, trying to stick Ahono, the fellow in the team, and the selectors are beginning to take over. But then Ladov says, you cannot put me to that. And the orange team have not been able to fight anyway. Quickly taking the ball in the middle. What can he do with the ball now? And it is still the selected team now. But then it's like opposite position. And the assistant referee was very smart there. He says it's free kick advantage. Free kick advantage at 2 minutes. By my own words, I've just played. He's placing a long one into the middle. What can he do now? And try to push the ball away. Quickly taking, but then, oh no. And a chance there. And try to play the ball away. And ball in the middle now. Who has the ball down now? Quickly taking. Cluster around the midfield now. And Tony, he tried to lay a pass on the finger there. That could be very dangerous, but then, oh no, Ladov says you cannot beat me to that. And he tried to hold the ball. What can he do? Danger, advantage now coming to. He takes a long one to nobody in particular. But he tried to pick an upside position. Oh, Sonny, how will he describe that moment?
I think that the Unity team from the Jamaica government has shown that they are really playing on their turf, and then the home advantage is coming to play. Now, last one for Ladov, control the ball now, comes number 13, gets it. Now, makes a long pass, and Ladov wins the ball back. There are two people on him. He did the last year, gets it. And he passes out of a back, gets it. Try to send a 20 of a pass. But that pass has been frustrated. But go see with Ladov. It's Ladov all the way. And then Ladov again tries to come back to first after. But that was taking for them again. Captain by side. Then the Ladov Jesse. It's on the loose ball going by side. And then number 7 taking it. Can he make a cross to the right area? The ball goes into touch. And that goal kick now coming to the Unity selected side from Sarah Sanaji team. They call themselves the fellow group of the local government team is a combination of Unity boys and their youth from the two local governments. And the back end again, outside position of play. This referee is tested and proved. This is the referee for crossing the fifth country. Free kick on the far side to the defense minister of the Edu. It's a little team, and he checks the feet, he back on the man to move forward. What can he do with the referee? He hit the ball high into space, and a header, and a chest up of the ball, and a feet back there, and honey of the ball, and free kick now coming to number 13 jersey for Ladov. It's a really fun team in Lorraine, Ladov, they play like Barcelona, and as before now, they like to do one touch football, And this guy now has the ball. What can he do? Try to send a special chip here. And that team has been protected. And then they win the ball by 2-12. It's not up to the lay the ball on the far side. Number 11 is moving now. And his name is Zachary Yao. And he put the ball to touch. And they throw Ladra LC. We are looking for TV Kelsey. And throw the ball like Bonito Tolori. He got number 4 Jesse. Meet me first two. What can he do? He has a bummer here. And he passes the ball now. And that ball has been protected. And this player is going to get attacked. But the first one is a lot of can they do? Yes, they lose one there. And the defense line says, you cannot pass me. That ball has been protected like empty when there's no stop. For the other guy, they lose one there. Hey! Outside position of play. Number 13, Jesse for the Ladra FC. And the first a longish one. It's only better than the head of the ball to take it. And now, and the super circle, that's where the action is. And the missing measure is still the ball around there gently. And the ball comes to Unity Points again. And they want to touch there. But that move has been projected. And the Unity Points are beginning to gain their momentum now. And they get over now. And they begin to move now. And the center out of the team. But they have been checkmate there. Outside position of play. Outside position of play. Outside recognized by member from the Karate Grassroots Soccer Association. Talking about man of Lekon Nawa of Olojo FC of Amayo. The coach of Olojo Football Academy of Amayo is here with us. The citizen of Sharia. And the goalkeeper comes down and he clears the path of Nega. And the head of them.
Announcing the arrival of the Honorable Commissioner for Local Government and Chieftaincy Affairs, Alhaji Muhammad Tambiri Haruna Kehunasa. Back to the hit of play as we welcome the Honorable Commissioner, a member of the Kwara State Executive Council here with us, representing the Governor himself here at this very from the fellow and of course the local government. The ministers are quickly beginning to find their relief. Quickly check it out. Let's see what is going to happen now as goal number one for Ladog. Who is the goal scorer of that match? Number what? Come on. Gola has got and won the 200 naira from Mr. Sporter. That's so motivating. And damage is now coming. That's so very dangerous. He's a session. Oh no. And that just went down to something about it. And it is still available. And of course, the team are trying to win themselves in corner kick because the goalkeeper reminds me of the one they call Fabien Barthez from Manchester United team. This is a Frenchman who did tremendously well. And this is another chance now from the Pelodio team now, the selected team. And it looks like an upside position. And the referee was very smart there. Kick advantage are coming to the Ladog boys now. And I've been told they have played 13 minutes going to 14. But then the referee says it's a free kick advantage. Free kick advantage are coming to the Pelodo Edu team. And of course, I quickly taking out a pass there now, trying to find route to nobody in particular. But then he moves around. And of course, he tried to take advantage. He clears the ball away. Advantage coming to. Excellency, the Executive Governor of Kwara State is preaching. And of course, we are abiding by that. And of course, there's a throwing advantage now. It's a free kick advantage. Free kick advantage are coming to Ladog. I can see that he rolls the ball down. Let's see what he's going to do. Is he going to take a long one into the... He takes a short one now into the midfield now. But then that move has been punctuated. And that looks like an infringement. And the referee says, it's fair play my game. And of course, you have to play the game gently. The crowd is clustering around gradually. And everybody is waiting. Football is about goals. And goals is what everybody is waiting for. And the goal has just been scored by Kola. And we just hope that more goals will be tolerated here. And put the long one into the middle. What can he do now? He has the ball down now. And he tries to beat his opponent. He couldn't. And then the referee says, I'm very close to the ball, always 10 meters to the ball, and you cannot beat my imagination. Fabian Batel of Valladolid now, let's see what he's going to do. And it's a long one into the periphery of the opponent, Sissoko. But then the header there, he tries to push the ball, that could be very dangerous. But then, oh no, he tries to clear the ball away. But then his advantage now coming to the Unity boys. But then the danger not advantage here, Ladom is rolling around there. Just the way Cirunado rolled yesterday to beat Grêmio. And of course, 3 months of his assistance with Real Madrid, he has been able to win 8 trophies, and of course no coach has ever done that, and he has also had a record. Don't forget, he won back to back talking about the Champions League, and of course he's still on course for the league this season. Except that I told my colleagues, Mario Abubakar, that if he is not taking, the gap is getting young, the gap is running now between Barcelona and Real Madrid in the La Liga. Throwing advantage now, coming to, don't forget, like we said, Gora United play against Niger Tornadoes of Mina in the first game in the Premier League, which will be coming up in January. Ahead of there, and we're trying to locate who now. But then it's Ladov now, trying to take control of the game. He tried to push the ball to number 9, and this is, oh no, and the Unity team has been able to take over now. Let's see what they will do. Will they be creative this time around and get the much better equalizer? He tried to treat the pass, and of course, flung the pass away, but then they are still in control of the game. It is still the Unity team now. He pushes the ball. It looks like an offside position. Oh no. Oh. Musa Ishaq, the coach of the team, says changes will be made any moment from now. But then the one they call Fabian Batez has been able to do a long one now. Who's going to connect it? Ah, nice and purple. Oh no. And danger not advantage, but the ref says is a goal. He was active, he was already considered the first goal. And of course, it's still Unity team conceding the goal here against Ladov. Aruna Mohamed now trying to push the ball in the middle, and advantage now coming. Tamir Tete is opponent. It looks like ugly. And it's a shot. Oh, overland here with breaking advantage. Breaking advantage coming to, and I can see number 10 of Ladov. That boy looks creative. Reminds me of JJ Okocha, the mercurial skill manufacturer of Nigerian football, who has done a lot, except that he did not win the African Footballer of the Year. While the gentlemen of Prefers are still waiting for their t-shirts, I know that Ladov will make arrangements for us, and of course it's a free kick advantage now. Free kick advantage are coming to who now? This is the Unity team from into and Feledo. Let's see what is going to happen. He's going to do. Oh, he does it! He's going to do. Beautiful like, oh no. And Fabian Batez. This is a very good goalkeeper, I must tell you. And of course, his reflexes is very sharp. And he's been able to ward off all the punctuating moves now. And goalkeeper to goalkeeper, Aruna Mohamed, he rolls the ball to his defender. And who is going to control the game? Mohamed Salib now, trying to find Umar. He pushes the ball. He was sleeping on duty. And of course, that's a chance now. He tries to push the ball. And no, no. And there's another pattern. And that is coming to the Unity team. If kids fall away, God, and that's exactly what everybody is looking forward to. Throwing advantage now. Sonia Hamage, so far, this or so. The pressure has been mounting on the Ladon boys, but then they've been able to ward off all the worries now. Advantage now. I try to push the ball away, but then both people for control there now. He tries to find who? To right foot back now, taking advantage now. He releases the ball and try to move now. Again, advantage. And try to do a cutting edge striking roll now. Advantage, he looks like an offside. Then he's a goal. He's a goal. Oh my God, it looks like an offside position, but then I never knew that the assistant going to 27 now, and it is in one run, and football is about to, it's not going to be very dangerous, and there he goes again. Advantage, it is trying to find who now, quickly take it, and there, and Kalipi is opponent, it's the orange team now trying to do what is called a tip to me and tip to you, and they try to beat his opponent quickly now, and there he goes again, that could be very good, it's a session, oh, and that
could be very dangerous. And he claims the ball away. And this is another chance now. Try to pick his opponent. But then he moves. Ball in front of it now. Oh no. And
he has the ball. He'll try to beat him now. Quickly take it. And can he beat his opponent? And there he goes again. And oh no. Back to the field of play. The game is still a Dindan Dapia, number 12 now. And of course, that's unsportsmanly conduct, you say. And that's one of the laws of the game, love 12. And the power and misconduct. And that's irrelevant for you. He follows the game tenaciously. And advantage now here for the Unity team. Let's see what is going to happen. And of course, closing around are the spectators now coming around. And I've been told that the spectators here are now more than 3,000.
I don't look at everybody. Advantage coming out. Can you score another goal now again, Batis?
Nigeria here is.
Thank you for your support, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, you are welcome to this year's edition of the Gida Champions Cup. And it's a match between Sariagi, Sare, selected 11 versus Ladop FC. And the scoreline at the moment is 1-1 to, you know, size one another up. But at the moment, this game seems to be taking shape as, you know, everybody expects there to be goal and there have been goals. And at the moment, it is Ladop trying to, you know, find how to unlock the defense of the Unity side. But at the moment, Unity prevails and the defense remains as solid as the rock of Gibraltar. Football, as we all know, is a divine game that is meant to unite. At the moment, I think I can see the try, the Unity, the Ladop FC attacking the team, trying to unlock the defense. But at the moment, the assistant referee has signaled.
You know, organized is meant to provide a kind of shield. And the corner kick is taken now, and at the moment, it wants to be an overhead kick for John. The exchanger has been averted at the end of the day, but then, not yet totally averted. Ladop FC is still in control, but that pass seems to be to whom it may concern, because it's to nobody in particular. A goal kick to Unity select side. Like I said, this is a call, final call to football. Football has fraternized, brought up across different divides, and we've seen that. And a goal kick now to the Unity select side, and the referee has just signaled the end of the first half. Ladies and gentlemen, the scoreline is 1-1, and this, the match is the 2017 edition of the Sariagi Sare Unity Cup, and right now, Megida Champions Cup. Okay, Megida Champions Cup, and with the scoreline at 1-1, the good side
on this particular game, we'd like to appreciate you very sincerely. If you're just joining us, we are celebrating Unity here in our community. Talking about Sariagi and Sare, I want to finish the goals. The first thing as we have been told will be recommended to all the coaches. But in the meantime, I want to say that since the gentlemen of the press will be hosted by Makama after the match, the chairman of Fiji will also support Makama.
Unity team, Haruna is out, and this goalkeeper, I will call him Fabian Batay, is in for the Unity team. They are clubbing typical orange jersey, the reminiscence of the orange boys of Fala. But my top boy is now losing possession at the center half of the field. And do that, he has the ball on him, and the Unity boys begin to move now. Start to see the boy, and send the center at the far side. And I start on this finger.
Going to enter the net or not, but then he took the bar. But then I want to say that he was not quick. His frequency was a bit short in there. And so Olejide is in for number four.
Boagide, I'm about to repeat the play now. Number 13, of Ladov trying to control the game. In the midfield now, about to put an opponent in bluntly. I decide to lay a pass to outside left, then he misses that. And this is another left footer now. It reminds me of the one you call a hockey double. And he quickly, oh no, ball is a touch advantage coming to the Unity team. Don't forget, we have another final by 3 o'clock today. It's going to be very colorful. We have certificates and prizes. The young stars of Saragi and of course Chunga United. It's going to be very tough. I'm going to wait for the match because I want mail from Chunga. And this is a chance now. Throwing advantage. I'm coming to the Unity team now. It took a long one. Reminds me of a walk on walk with it. Of Rangers International or the one they call Les Moses of Olori. Who are high pointer thrower for Nigeria in their days. Of course, back to rifle back now, trying to find the midfielder now, and quickly taking out. That is a quarter head striking rule, like Cristiano Ronaldo, but he misses that, and he's throwing advantage coming to the Unity team. Quickly throwing now, he controls the ball, trying to find the defender, and what can he do? Can he change the ball around? He deals with a loose finger now, he crosses the ball into the middle, and who's trying to take it now, quickly take it, oh no, and he's trying to do it last now, and that could be very dangerous, but then the ref is in that last position. Don't forget, like Bayo Abubakar mentioned, it's a pre-tournament match. Of course, I have to bring the communities together. And of course, the starting list of each half, we ended the first half, this is the second half, and after two, we have played 9 minutes. Cooking, taking now. And of course, it's taking advantage with 1 minute to end the game. It is cutting from advantage to Momonsa Sports Police Facebook to get all the details of all these matches across the world, including the pictures and of course even the video shot. You can get it on Appeal Sports Pro News. And there it goes again. And of course, don't forget we're also doing live streaming here. The live streaming is also on for hundreds of these matches. And we are beginning to say that the world is a global one. And of course, Sarai Gishare is known now everywhere, even in the United States. Of course, it's going to be a corner kick now, number 10. What can he do? And he slows down, reminds of JJ Okocha game. And he pushes the ball. And of course, the goalkeeper. Oh no. And oh no. The goalkeeper has really not been pressured. He's done warm up. And oh. The sun is affecting the goalkeeper. Don't mind. But when you see a sun like that, it's a reflection that you have to take a seat. And the goalkeeper is taking it now, trying to move again.
With what you saw right now, it appears. Oh, that's an offside position for the three of them. What we saw just now is not the fault of the goalkeeper, because at the moment, the scotches are like almost at the center of the universe, and we expect it to, you know, have an effect on their vision, particularly for area ball. That's why you see some goalkeepers like Lucinavet done in the first half in any match like of this nature. Ladies and gentlemen, the score is 1-1, and I can see the...
Beautiful goal there! Goal number 2 for Ladov! And of course, I want to say that Coach Lumarok is happy now, because his boys have been able to hit on target. 2-1 advantage to Ladov. And of course, the game is still growing. And of course, I've been told it's about 19 more minutes to end the game. And of course, France is coming to Ladov. Let's see whether the fellow Dun and of course, the local government or Unity team will be able to change the face of the game. Back to the field of play, quickly taking out. It's the Unity team now trying to control ball in the midfield now. Can he beat the second? He beats the man. And he's trying to lay a pass now. And to outside left now. He beats him badly. And of course, he brought him down. And that looks like a yellow card. It's a caution card. Number 5 has been cautioned. And of course, that's the second yellow card in this particular game. By my own record. The player is warming up, guys. And of course, now that the flag of the assistant referee is up, that change is going to be executed any moment from now. And of course, the center referee, Iraloi Kapiru, is about to go in for who? And of course, Radu is expected to be out in a moment. Don't forget, there's another final after this particular game, starting by 3 o'clock. The youngsters of Saragi
and of course Sunga United. The competition is known as Elijah Abumetu Cup, and of course Elijah Abumetu will be here, I've been told, and the winner will smile home with special prizes. That change has been effected. Let's see whether it's meet. Okay, may shake it now.
We want to appreciate the FA chairman of Sare and Saraji for a wonderful job that we have done. I'm told that they want to put this together. And I want to quickly ask the FA chairman of Saraji to please give us the pictures of the matches for the Megiddo Champions Cup, because they're going to be announcing it on radio and television starting from tomorrow. The pictures of all the matches and the names of all the teams that have registered for the Megiddo Champions Cup. Please, every chairman of Saraji, to please come to the commentary arena and let us have the pictures for tomorrow's game. Just now for Lador, and that ball was going to touch, and the goal kick now coming to the goalkeeper. And the far side there, lays the ball high with the right foot, and on the center of the field, and the header by Lador boy, taking the back of Benja, who controls the ball, and the telegraph pass, and the far side, and the goalkeeper of Lador comes collecting and kicks the ball aimlessly. And Kabapa going to touch, and he goes into touch, and the throw is not coming to the Unity boys. Orange boys, I can say orange boys from Saraji, that's what they're wearing. And the head and out of Benja is going back for Cup. He gives the ball, and he chance again. Oh, second clearance now. And the tomato is deep for Lato Hope to use at the grassroots. Talking about Alhajuma, Alubu. And the devil keeps down, and the head out, and then there's like a man right here. He's killed the man, and he's going to move that 18. He has him again, can he beat this? Oh, the defender says he can't pass me. And the head out, and that ball comes to who? Zachary Yao, number 11 Jesse. Skillful player, special and proof player, and a champion, a national champion. Happy World Cup of 2013 in 2013. Players number 11 Jesse for Lando FC. His name is Zachary Yao, I know him very well. I was the coach in 2013 in Benin City at Tokyo Stadium. Lawa Lekon to come to the commentary for me and receive this arena to come and brief us on the pictures and the nature. Lawa Lekon, if you're around, you are leader at the commentary board.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, once again, the final of the 2017 edition of Sare Sare Agi Unity Cup, aka Megiddo Champions Cup. Mr. Sonny Ahamioge, you will agree with me. The number 11, the person playing 11 for the Unity Select side, is dancing run down the flank, is something to behold. It's a spectacle to behold, and so far so good. It has been a controlled affair between the two of them. I can see somebody trying to do something extraordinary there. Something you can only expect from a Lionel Messi, a Cristiano Ronaldo, or an Iniesta. At the moment, it is Lador FC trying to, you know, try to unlock the impregnable defense of the Unity side. But at the moment, they seem to have, you know, taken that off. And that is our goal kick to the corner kick to the Unity Select side.
Ladov has decided, the MD of Ladov Technology has decided, Alhajuma Balogun has decided to present the ball case to each of the teams. And of course, just to express his happiness for the unity that he has seen here today. So immediately after the match, about 15 more minutes to go, the two teams will line up, have handshakes with the Honorable Commissioner, and of course, the Executive Chairman, and of course, the captain will wait behind to officially receive the ball. This is another play now. It's a free kick advantage now. This is Fabien Patel of Lador FC now. And he tried to push the ball in the middle, but then a header there. Who's going to control the game now? Of course, he's not doing nothing. And he looks around now. To who? And try to beat him flatly. Quickly take it. Oh no. And this is another chance now. It looks like an offside position, but the referee says, I have seen that. You cannot pick me to it. Offside position, not inside. Of course, anybody that watched the game between Manchester United at Old Trafford against Man City will agree with me that instead of Jose Mourinho to continue to attack, he decided to defend and he paid dearly for it. Because the best form of
defense is to attack. And this is exactly what we expected Mourinho to do. And he's not doing that because he's somebody who is very rigid when it comes to analysis of the game. And this is another chance now. Oh no. And that looks like a foul. And the referee says are very close. The rule of the game says that referee must always be 10 minutes after the ball. And this is exactly what the referee is doing. Quickly take it out. Back to the pitch. And try to put it up on number 10 now. It reminds me of the one who called on. Oh no. Can he put his opponent? And the Orange Gang team are looking more good now in the attack. If they are good to go. And very good. Outside left now. What are you doing? Is he going to cross the ball? And the fans to be a number 10. Oh no. He's not behind the corner. It's on. Oh no. He couldn't connect it. He couldn't connect it, maybe because of the orange they are putting on. And here, trial is not effective here. And of course, that change has been effected quickly. Number 7 is coming in for who? The scorer of the first goal, the man who got 1,200 almost immediately for scoring the first goal of this match. And this is another chance quickly taken out. There he goes again. Advantage it is. And
Nigeria wins! That was 2 kilometers above the goalpost. And I heard the time of Saragi Afe to give us his t-shirt and the name of all the teams that are participating in the Medina Champions Cup. Kudos for the German. We are grateful for names here that will go to Para United for trials. Also, we will send some names to Suleiman of ABL. So we have 6 players here that we most recommend to the coaches of ABL and Para United. And the chance now, this is a brand new ball. And it's the best line saying you can't beat me. And that ball is the contact like MCA with the social. And the ball goes to the touch. And the player is now coming to Saragi Unity Park. And the pressure, can they do good? Can they do the ball? And that defender says you can't beat me. Let's go, get up the ball. And that ball, big kick there. And the big man, and I'm going to Mr. Ford. He said that you have talent. I want to put it properly. We have a balance of talent in Saragi and Zara. Can we start for this tournament? Please. We have a lot of talent here. And I want to praise the coaches at this grassroots level for bringing this voice up to this level. And I want to recommend that the Saragi is going to come and meet us. We are going to arrange for a tournament between this team and Para United. And also this team and APS. That goes into touch. So you're coming to Lagos FC. This is the one they call the number 6 jersey for Lagos FC. And his name is Paru. And he's going to be like the PSG boy from Brazil. And hands by game, 2 times. Number 7, new replacement. His name is Toby. That's hands by handling. And the free kicks are coming to the Unity boy. Good combination of players for the 2 sides. And a new level! And it's just a game for the Unipers! And the third team! A chance! Can you take it off? It's taken off! Oh, that was a better kick! It was a jump of the bar and a corner kick must go. It looks as if the boys from Toronto, they are both sides of the weather here. The weather is taking a toll from Loka and the Jazz are similar. Corner kick! And on this week of the corner, and the header! Goalkeeper Bertrand, Xavier Bertrand, in the case of Bayern United. And Bayern was saying that Mourinho has decided to convert attack into defense. And the free man there, and a free kick coming to the Unity boys wearing orange jersey. I must appreciate the coach of the Unity boys, the man has done a young man of Musa Ishak. That is his name. What can he do to make sure that he equalizes this game? That's the coach for Ifeanyi and the local government team, Musa Ishak. And I want to say that the Honorable Commissioner is here. And I want you to send the message to the Commissioner for Sports that we have a lot of talent at the grassroots right in this area. And it's possible to come here and organize the tournament here. It's just a game. And the ball goes into touch. And it's going. Must come to the and to the Melody boys who are not, they are taking a lot of energy. I mean, and the guys are, if you like, call it a body point. To energize your system. And in the first life on the door. Now, play makeup for his side. He's coming back. This boy left with his back. His name is Anari Yao. And the little one now comes. So, number 6, Jesse. And he throws the ball low. And the goalkeeper comes collecting. Goalkeeper and Jones. He just imported. An imported goalkeeper from Lagos that came to participate in the Megita Champions Cup. As we are talking to you now, this match is being streamed live on all the radio stations that we are here today. And the live stream is on the fast right there, the first of the event on the NG. And the first line of Lado is holding very well. And the Unity points are tormenting the Lado points like Jamaica Marine in the Battle of Panda. And Lado say you can't pass me again. Zakari Yao again, this is possessed on and the day time, and begin to move. Can you tell the boys of your team? Can you tell? It's not a loose one. That player is tired. And the ball came to touch for a goal kick to Ladon boys. As a player is body point. A loose one now. A chance. What a beat. What
a beat! I thought that it was going to be 2-2, but he lost that particular chance. And so, the game is not over yet, but it is over. Fire Abubakar. And now I can see that the referee has called for the end of the match. And of course, the Ladon FC won. But they have a special prizes. And of course, the two teams should please line up. And of course,
started taking this assault as the match progressed. So I began to ask myself, is this captain the unity? Because I am telling the reflection of the difference between the two sides. And I asked my conclusion is no. If you look at the amount of pressure mounted by the unity boys on the Ladon FC defense, you want to agree with me that the scoreline is not a reflection. Credit the unity side for their fighting spirit, their never say die attitude, and their, you know, their ability to be a number 10 and their number 11 was not quite angry. Nevertheless, we want to put it to the team and
winning our culture. I mean, because some money met in the company could come begin this organized. So they Liberia, Sudan, and even small Syria alone and Senegal come begin form Goliath for David like Nigeria. So, but thank God, say thank you today. Don't just one shake course so that we could really come down to prepare for the bigger competition. No shaking. You want that caution. What day is she? Oh, she could have one year cutter. Not today. Now let us rewind to 1980 when the Super Eagles really started the show. I beg like Baja. Hey. 1980 nations. I remember Nigeria winning. I'll never forget the Germany too.
I'm very, very happy today to make this proposal to petition. The Lazov proposed this to complement the effort of state government to cement the unity between two communities. And we are happy. We want to start from the vulnerable section of the community. And they are the centerpiece of unity and the crisis. But now they choose to unite. We thank God for that. With this achievement, we want you to continue social interaction, to continue so that we are going to solidify the unity among us. Please, we thank you, Madam, for putting up this. May God award you and may you prosper in your endeavor. He is giving back to the community. In fact, he's not taking any kubo from anybody. But he has the interest of the two communities. He wants us to come together. Please let us come together and become one. Thank you very much.
And honorable Mr. President, the Commission has just said the aim of this tournament is to solidify the relationship between the communities. We are very, very, very good. The sake of all students in the occasion is a great achievement to us. This did not manifest. It is during this our tenure that this city last night to feel very great honor to witness it like this. May Almighty Allah continue in infinite mercy to solidify this relationship. Let it last, let it be an everlasting relationship. No crisis will ever come to this community in the name of God. Thank you and God bless.
So my just to concur what they have said. If anybody is prepared, you will not know what to say again because you said it all. I've been part of this struggle for about 10 years. I think God has had a day to witness this kind of relationship. I thank God for this kind of thing. Don't let it be ceremonial like this. Let us continue with it ever and ever. Thank you and God bless.
A great moment for us, not just only you. I think a great opportunity for the joint of our LOC, the MOC from Lori, and also the Sarel and Saraki LOC. The aim and objective of this great tournament is to see how you know, continue what our forefathers, what our leaders have been doing to make sure that we are one. And the message here is just let there be peace in our communities. That's just only the simple message we are here to do. For the white generation and incoming generation, let there be peace. Thank you very much.
I'm going to talk to you a long time. Today. To the pay, you look at the way. Ojo nkan to se pataki si awa yuti awon agba wa awon ti gaga awon meje awara lole bi o le se ri yi o tun mo wa pupo esu ene ko olorun ba wa le dan le community leji a dupe fo olorun ba a de dupe lowo yin chairman leji awon dupe lowo e to sokun ba e to sele yi olorun ba lo mo ba wa pe o soke olorun ba lo mo ba wa pe o soke olorun le ke pari su ma lai esu ene ko olorun ba wa leji na awa o ta ma o esu e ma wa ti gba lo ba ji da ta won pe isagi ije bo bi pe ni na be ije ra ije bo wa ya ti a mo gba bo ti a ma i fe lo du ije bo won bo no ya bo ta ni ni na ti bo le commissioner ba i tu e ti a e fo de ji no so ko na le fo yin na le bi a yi na e fo ko mo le je ga na so ku ju ya yi e bo na ba ri pa bi mo mo le
I'm here to analyze one of my other to clear the competition. I'm glad to organize it. I'm going to say that I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to say that I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and
My name is Sauda Ndaji Seibu from Forest State for the Defense.
Go ahead.
I have nothing to say again, rather all my elders are saying a lot. I will just appreciate the elders. As we want it, God will help us. May God continue to help us. Let us be Allah Laila Hilahu Allah Yukayumulata Huzu Sangatola Rumu Mati Samawati Mati Lai Mazan Lazi is calling the Ulai Zini Allah Mati Nadi Oman for Allah to be shared in the Indian of Masha was Sakusi Samawati Lai Lai Shumawa Sudan Adipa.
But
that's all I do.
As
I said,
you know, the eyes of it. Thank you very much. On that note, Captain, where are you? That's all, congratulations as a symbol of unity. Live together. Congratulations. Even though without your captainship band, congratulations. As your closing prayer.
We thank God for everything. We thank God for making everything possible for us to live. And we pray to God Almighty and Allah to let this unity continue. So we pray to God Almighty and Allah, all those things that are around today,
thank you.
Arise, O compatriots, Nigeria's Olubi, to serve our father's land with love and strength and faith. The labor of our heroes shall never be in vain. To serve with heart and mind, one nation burning freedom, peace and unity.
Thank you very much.
Them to solidify the two communities so that they are for the peace, that the peace shall reign. And the group, the target group of the state government is the vulnerable group and their youth. And in his infinite mercy, God has just bring up one of the youths. And I said, okay, I want to bring these two people together. And they come together. We have a tournament. It was free of rancor, acrimony. Everybody was joyous. And we thank God. The officials and the media crew that came here, they also cover the tournament very well. We are very, very grateful.
Thank you very much. How will you urge other communities to emulate this kind of gestures?
Yes. In fact, if the youths are targeted, then we don't have any problem. These youth, the youth leader in Share and the youth leader in Sharagi, they came together, they cemented the relation between them, and they now told the elders, "You go, your time is up.
Yes.
We are going to live together." And then once it is done like that, in fact, the devil will be put to shame.
Thank you very much, Ladi Tambiri. Let's talk to the
very fantastic. Very, very fantastic. We really appreciate it. We are all to witness this.
Alright, this is expected.
I said we have been looking forward to witness this type of work. And God has actualized what it is. As I said earlier, God is going to solidify it. This type of things, we should be witnessing it so that the relationship between the two communities should be an everlasting one.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. What Madam did to us in this area. Yeah, we have been looking for this kind of situation to come up, to bring youth together. We don't have it in our mind to be marry each other, to do business together. Now. But now that it started with football match now, you know, I told you I've been in this struggle for over 10 years. So for me to still be around now, to witness it like this, it's a real gift. I appreciate it. Thank you.
And I thank you about the two communities. The primary objective of this is to, you know, encourage our youth that there's no reason for us to fight each other. And the only way for us to live together is for us to create peace among ourselves so that there will be development. And we'll be able to sustain development in both communities. That's, I think, the main message is that, you know, let there be peace in our communities. That is just the main message.
Thank you very much.
I forgot to tell us your name.
My name is Omar Barugogo, MD and CEO of Adopt Technology Service Limited.
Thank you very much.